It's a game for the uninhibited. Our stars this week, Markie Post and Tom Poston. Watch their bodies do the talking on Body Language. And here's the star of Body Language, Tom Kennedy.
Hello. Thank you. Hi, gang. Good to see you all. Welcome to Body Language. Thank you. Thank you very much. This is the game for the uninhibited. Let's meet our players. Markie Post is here from Fall Guy.
How are you?
Happy to have you on the show.
I'm so happy to be here. Thank you.
Big things are happening to you, Markie. I see you all over the place. You're much in demand now, and it couldn't happen to a nicer gal.
Oh, thank you, Tom.
You're just doing a good job. And Fall Guy, you like it?
I love it.
Good.
I love it. It's a little less strenuous than this show.
Yeah, I know. Here's where you work for your
That's
buck.
That's right. Oh, you know it.
This is Kelly Zapp. Kelly Zapp. Tell us about yourself, Kelly Zapp.
I'm originally from Portland, Oregon. I moved to Los Angeles about 2 years ago because of an interest in the entertainment industry. And I'm a bartender and a waiter. And I enjoy bodybuilding and volleyball.
Well, good. She's chewed on and off camera. She is on, isn't she? One of our very finest actors, Mr. Tom Poston.
Thank you. Thank you, Tom. I like anybody with a name Tom.
Yeah. When we look at that Newhart show and we see that guy, the character's name is...
George Utley.
George. And he is so naive and plodding. You're a great actor.
Why? That's the way
you're just a fine actor. Love the show. Love you on it.
Thank you. I'm glad to be on it.
Thank you. Wendy, what's your last name?
Gill.
Wendy Gill. Tell America about Wendy Gill, would you?
Well, I just graduated from Cal State Long Beach, and I got a degree in business marketing. I'm originally from Palm Springs, California, and I enjoy traveling, which is what I plan to do this summer.
Good. And then after that, go out looking for a job, huh?
Get serious.
Good for you, Wendy. Well, folks, the object of our game, Body Language, is to act out a series of words to help you solve a puzzle. And so, Markie, we're going to ask you and your team to do the first job. You get up there in the acting position, Markie. Kelly, you get over there in the receiving position. Right there. All right, now. Markie, we're going to give you five words that will fit into a puzzle, and we'll show you that puzzle a little bit later on. Right now, you use simply body language to act out as many words as you can for Kelly to guess. And the more words he guesses, the easier it will be to solve that puzzle. We'll show you the words one at a time. You'll have 60 seconds to act out as many as possible. And you can pass any time you want. Come back to the words if there's time remaining on the clock. Okay?
Okay.
All right.
Let's have Kelly.
All right, Kelly. Let's have 60 seconds. Here's the first word. And go.
Something behind you. You have a tail.
Hey, you got it. Next word.
You're frightened. You're afraid. You're faint. There's a helicopter above you. You're around a... You're flying with one wing. You're hula dancing. It's a type of dance. Or a helicopter. A type of dance. It's a whirling. It's a break dancing.
You've got a next word.
Pass it.
Pass next word.
You're pulling something out. You're starting a motor. You're starting a lawnmower. There's an engine. Something round. It's up high. It's in your hair. It's above your head.
You can pass if you wish.
I'm gonna pass.
Pass. Next word.
You're
I'm
sound.
Pass again.
Pass. Next word.
Pass again.
Pass. Next word.
Okay.
Repeating, Kelly.
It's way. It's high. Something tall. Tall. High. Slender. A hat. A top hat.
You've got it. Top. Yeah. Next word. The head had nothing to do with it, really. She was looking for top as opposed to bottom, and you got it.
I'm sorry. Oh.
Now, I have to say this in front of America. You got breakdancing, but I'm sadly disappointed in you. You didn't get down there and spin on your head like you're supposed to.
Didn't they get down, they put their little legs up, and they go around like that?
Yeah.
Come on, Kelly. I did the best I could.
Markie, get over there and sit down. You did a good job. That was good. You got three words, Kelly. Oh, yeah. Now, see, I'll bet if Tom Poston were up there, he would have gone right into the break. One of the greatest break dancers this side of the Mississippi. Oh, yeah. Not too many people know that, including Tom. But anyway, let's look at this puzzle, please. I'll read it for you here, Kelly. He never went blank with blank, but he looked great in blank, 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 and blank. And now here are the three words you earned. Here's the first one. He never went break dancing. Next. Top. Next. Tails. He never went breakdancing with blank, but he looked great in top blank, 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 and tails for $100.
It would be Gene Kelly?
Is it Gene Kelly? It is not. And that means that Wendy comes over here and gets in the game. Wendy, you don't have to do any pantomiming. All you have to do is look up there and tell me which blank you want next. We'll go back and forth between you until one of you solves the puzzle. Wendy?
How about five?
You got it. White. Look great in top, blank, white, blank, and tails. Wendy?
I'm going to say Fred Astaire.
Is it Fred Astaire?
Yeah! You got it. Fred Astaire.
If you had a second chance, what would you have said? That's what I thought. Can we see the rest of the puzzle, please? He never went breakdancing with whom? With Ginger. But he looked great in top hat, it's got to be, white tie, and tails, Ginger, or their Fred Astaire, rather. $100 for you, Wendy. Congratulations. The first team to reach $500 wins our game and a chance to shoot for $10,000. We'll be back with Tom Poston's team right after this.